This record is really just about beats and vocals and that empty space between them.
When we're writing stuff, we're often inspired by groove or sounds. It's not just a song idea.
We both came in wanting it to feel really hi-fi, really saturated. And the same thing applied to how we wanted it to feel emotionally, too. We wanted it to be vulnerable and open. That was sort of our point of departure, just this sort of degree of intensity. And there it is, right in front of me.
When we set out to make this record, we knew that we wanted to produce it ourselves. And we figured the best way to do that would be by building the studio, a place for us to try to make something really personal.
That was really liberating. It also made us approach the sounds with more care and more love. Moth flying towards the flame is a cliche that everyone's familiar with. You're attracted to things that are bad for you and can't help it. The spirit of a moth really sort of fit the music. This feeling of like persistence and innocence and fragility in a hard place.
We started with some sounds. Caroline had given me some sounds. I put them on the MPC so you can play them and you're not just placing things in a computer.
And we'd make a beat out of that, and then the melodies would come on top of that. And then I'd take it, come in here, and just be able to run around the room and sing and then get back on, record it, you know, go back in the room 2 hours later with lyrics saying, okay, here it is. I really wanted there to be a feeling in all the vocals, really vivid. Just seeing my life for what it is and trying to capture emotions that were actually happening.
Great.
Patrick's sort of like just a force of nature. I mean, it makes sense that he comes from a jazz background because everything he does is essentially improvised. And then later he'll sort of go back and pick it apart and, you know, turn it into a garden.
Caroline always surprises me. She's always ready to take things to the next level. Always has an idea. If it's real.
How you feeling, Danny? You want to do some passes?
A lot of inspiration came through improvising. All of the rhythm, it was all hand played, as opposed to using like a sequencer. So it had this really laid back groove. It just felt like, it just felt, it felt good. Take a look.
The energy of New York definitely made it into the record. You can't get away from the eclecticism of music in the city. That sort of combination of anonymity and possibility is intoxicating.
They're calling.
I'm looking at the phone call.
Hello? Because we just have a few more tweaks. Everything is just so close. Yeah, I think we're gonna be ready to master it tomorrow.
Told you I have to go. what you're really working towards is joy. And it's not always, you know, they're trying to capture the feeling of being happy necessarily, but I don't know. So surprise can be joy as well. And also sort of expressionism too. Like there's something that you're trying to convey that's abstract, and then when the sound accurately can hit on that feeling that you haven't even been able to describe, that's a moment of joy too.
This is always a special moment. Chris Gehringer, we've worked with him on everything that Chairlift has ever put out. This album might actually be done.
Normally there's this weird like postpartum thing where I'm like, it can't be done, we can fiddle with it more, and now I'm like, let's be done.
I'm either gonna take it home and sleep with it, or I'm gonna take it out drinking. I'm not gonna listen to it, that's for damn sure.
Oh, take it out with you. Don't lose it. Don't drop it on the ground. Chairlift record leaks into the gutter.
Maybe we should make two copies just in case I do lose it.
I love it. This is what I've been waiting for these guys. Their beats and their melodies now are just they're at another level. Caroline's vocals are just so amazing. You know, it's been amazing to watch these two grow.